Hello and welcome to the second screen lifecycle lesson, where we will deal with interaction. If you haven't gone through the first lesson covering the web paradigm and normal rendering in OutSystems, please do so before proceeding. So how do users interact with your web application done in the OutSystems platform? They start by following a link that will render the screen that they will interact with, and this is covered on the first lesson. Then, they fill in any of the inputs and press a button to submit the result to the server. The act of following links is associated with the concept of navigating. Likewise, the concept of pressing buttons is normally and historically been associated with the act of actually submitting user input. It's worth noting that while in the past the link HTML widget was strongly associated with the act of navigating, and the button HTML widget was strongly associated with the act of submitting user input, in this day and age, the two widgets are actually interchangeable. It's worth noting, though, that regardless of which method we're talking about, navigation or submit, a new request will be sent to the server, who will in turn send us a new response. Let's start by discussing the navigate method. This is a strictly client-side way of interacting with the page. When you click a link or a button that is of type navigate, your browser will immediately request a URL that is different from the current screen. The destination of a link or button with the method navigate can be either a screen or any URL on the internet. Navigating to a destination uses the HTTP GET method. This means that any parameter to the target URL or screen is sent in the URL itself, in the query string. Any of the inputs that you may have filled in on the current screen will be ignored and not submitted to the server, and your browser will actually show the URL of the target that you're pointing to. In summary, when you do a navigate, you're actually intending on starting a brand new set of interactions in the target, in the destination of this navigate. The submit method is different. It carries with it the intention of interacting with the server and having code run in the server in response to this interaction. You can choose as the destination of a button or link with the method submit to be a screen action of the current screen, a target screen, or an external URL. By far, the most common case is for the destination to be a screen action of the current screen, where you will have code that will process the inputs that the user has submitted and maybe write any outputs to the database. Submitting to a screen uses the HTTP POST method for communication. This means that the input fields, as well as any parameters, are sent in the body of the request to the server, and therefore what you type into the screen will actually be taken into account in the execution of the screen action. The browser will show the URL of the current screen, and when you actually complete processing the data that was sent at the end of the screen action, you can actually use server-side navigation to move to a different screen. As mentioned, the most common destination for a submit is a screen action. A screen action can contain code for any purpose, but it normally focuses on logic that directly deals with the inputs sent from the screen. This includes things like validating what was submitted, processing and storing the results in the database. Don't worry, because we will cover validation in more detail in a later lesson. A screen action has in scope all the form inputs submitted to the server, all the input parameters, both of the screen and of itself, all the local variables, both of the screen and of itself, and it can even access outputs from the preparation, although this is highly inadvisable due to performance considerations. Now, at the end of all the code that is written in a screen action, the flow needs to end with one of two nodes. It can finish in an end node or in a destination node. The end node is the most interesting one because it carries with it the intention of staying in the same screen. What happens is that the server will cycle back to the preparation, re-execute that, rebuild the screen, and resend it for rendering completely to the user. It's worth noting that the cycle back via the end node will preserve the values of all the variables and all of the inputs in the current screen, allowing you to seamlessly simulate continuous interaction with the same screen. You can also end a screen action using a destination node. This carries the intention of actually jumping, moving to a different context. The target of a destination node can either be a screen on your application or an external URL to your application. Depending on the type of the target, you'll actually get a different icon for this destination node, as can be seen on the right-hand side of the slide. It's worth stressing here the difference between finishing a screen action with an end node and finishing a screen action with the destination that is the current screen. Although at first glance this might look like the same thing, it actually behaves differently. If you use a destination node to the current screen, you're actually going to be resetting all of the context of the current screen. This means that all variables will revert to their default values, unlike the end node that preserves the variables, as we've explained previously. And this is it for screen lifecycle interaction. It's worth noting that we've talked about navigation and we talked about the common type of submit. Ajax type submits will actually be handled in the later lesson. See you later!